Reactor Assault started as a what-if question of, if we could make a big-budget space opera, what would a small snippet of that look like?
We knew we wanted a team of Marines assaulting a ship's reactor, and to have them be attacked by a giant robot.
We began experimenting with design ideas, culminating in our prototype robot. We kept some of the prototyped elements, like the single glowing eye, but we also discovered design elements that weren't necessary for our desired effect, like his legs.
Our main shape is a truncated icosahedron. We decided this after the prototyping phase in our project.
Next was the decision to add the hexagon lattice, which gave another level of texture to the set. The issue was we only got to laser cut a sheet of the chipboard. I traced the pattern onto other boards and hand cut them.
After prototyping the robot, we began redesigning him. I modeled the torso, head, and hands in CAD for 3D printing. We experienced 17 printer crashes and failures across our 15 different parts, but after a week and a half of printing and reprinting, we had all the parts we needed.
We decided we wanted our human characters to be futuristic while also being recognizable to us today.
My idea for approaching this was utilizing gear that would make sense to modern sensibilities, and then make choices that would break from the conventional mold. Their camouflage is yellow, their visors glow, the pads are the most sci-fi construction and rollerblading pads I could get my hands on, and the helmets completely obstruct the face. But the features are designed in a way that make them feel alien, while giving enough reference points to still make body language readable.
We had problems with the shape being too loose. The solution, with the help of JE, was making an outside frame to support it. After gluing in the lattice, it was time to paint. We decided on a name to describe the texture, which was Space Swan. Karen pointed me in the right direction, and I got to work finishing the paint in one night.
The pieces were glued together, primed with filler primer, sanded, primed with normal primer, and sanded even more, slowly working up the grits to achieve a smooth finish. After a couple coats of metallic paint, our bot looked too shiny and new, so to fix this, we decided to junk up the bot. We added pieces from model kits and deliberately dinged up and scarred them. These changes were followed by another round of painting and weathering to highlight the imperfections. The arms and neck were constructed out of corrugated tubing, which provided a sci-fi appearance and easy posability. Another issue we ran into was that the arms looked too loose and cartoonish. To fix this, arm detail was added with piston-like mechanisms that brought them to life. To finish the bot off, gave it life with a bright blue LED behind his eye and electroluminescent wire wrapped around him.
Having access to the KLRU facility for our short film gave us freedom and opportunities we wouldn't have had otherwise. Our project's nature presented unique challenges, like the costumes limiting Dylan and AJ's visibility to near zero, meaning I needed to help them into position each take and give them feedback on their movements as they learned to feel their way through each shot of the film. We did run into some technical difficulties along the way, but quick thinking and tape saved the day and made shooting an incredibly enjoyable process.
Slam.
I learned a lot about I learned a lot about communication and collaboration from this project. We learned together about making puppets, building miniature sets, and honestly, this project has just reminded me about what I love about the creative process.
This project has greatly improved my skills in communication, building, and just general knowledge of practical special effects. It's been an absolute pleasure building, breaking, and fixing the Reactor Assault.
I absolutely love this project. The fact that it was student-driven and we were able to bring our ideas to the table and make them come to life is a huge factor. Working with Reactor Assault was an absolute pleasure, and I couldn't have asked for better partners. Thank you.